change your hair color. You can change your wife. You can change your religion. You can change your sexual orientation. But when it comes to gender, it's like it's too sacred. I came to the US to fully transition, to live as a woman 24/7, which I couldn't do at that point in Argentina. So I came to do it here. My name is Cecilia, Cecilia Gentili. I am originally from Argentina. I am a transgender woman. I started transitioning in the 80s and 90s, you know.
It's never enough mascara for me.
We were very new into democracy, was a lot of corruption. Being trans wasn't something, you know, normal, wasn't something that, you know, people were dealing with very well at that time. That's why I decided at the end of the 90s to flee the country and, you know, look for a better place for me. I work in New York City and live in New York City.
All right.
I work in a community health center that tried to get people closer to medical services. I am a board member for an organization called Trans Bodies, Trans Self that is coming out with a book. I work for Persist also as a volunteer. Persist is another organization that is trying to help folks working in a sex trade closer to medical services. I also work as a consultant for the LGBT Center of New York City, for the GIP, that is a gender identity project. I consult for them for special cases, for special events, and I facilitate a group that is an intervention. It's an HIV intervention based on empowering people
to support.
One of the best things that I can do for my community is try to educate everybody.
It's at our next event, and we are also
my own people don't know that, you know, the rights that they can get, and I thought, like, if I can just make a difference and help them, that would make a lot to me.
A lot of times when we look at the media, our lives are portrayed as, you know, that we're criminals, that we're not able to, you know, have decent jobs, or we're not able to contribute to society. In the work that we're doing here, the work that Cecilia has been doing for the past few years, it has been to break a lot of that, you know, that perception that, you know, we are contributing members to community, and that we, you know, we are not broken.
Violence against transgender people is everywhere. You know, it's still a lot to do.